Welcome, we'll start with Yojana April today, and this is one of the very different themes that have been picked up, but very, very important from your prelims examination perspective. So a lot of match the following questions, statement questions can be part of this. We'll understand those as we proceed. Now, initially, it talks about the various crafts in India, the regions where various crafts have been developed, India's presence in Germany in ambient, and that's the future is handmade, and the various fabrics we would be discussing. So as we know, handicraft is a section which employs a lot of labor, so it's low cost sector, employment opportunities are tremendous. Then you have a lot of foreign exchange earning coming in from this section. It not only have the developments in wooden or fabrics or textile, but besides that you have jewellery and other crafts like Bidri craft from Karnataka is one of the very renowned crafts, has been developed over the years and over the generations. So artisans have been recognized for their uniqueness, for their passion, and a lot of artisans believe that a bunkar has been engaged so much that they don't have even time to weave their own coffin. So that was the idea or the extent of the weavers and the demand that was there decades ago. The things have gradually changed, but how they have evolved, we would be understanding that. Handicrafts plays a major role. In India, you have nearly 70 lakh handicraft artisans which are part of the system, of which 20 lakh are related only to the carpet sector, which is indeed a very significant number. And there are 35 crafts which are categorized under endangered craft. Now, what are these endangered crafts are important? You have jewellery from Assam, you have Rogan painting, Sanji craft, Ganifa cards. So those are some of the important ones, and then there are numerous crafts which are registered under GI or geographic indication tag. For example, the Kashmir paper mache, then you have the Madhubani paintings, you have the Katputli art. So those are some of the uniqueness that India has. So 35 we say are the endangered crafts and 92 are the GI tags or geographically indication act. Under those, they are there. Now, numerous awards have been given for recognizing the handcrafts. You have the Shilp Guru Award, National Merit Certificate, Design Innovations are some of those. Artisans have been recognized by the Office of the Development Commissioner of Handicrafts, which is a major agency which takes care of the handicrafts across India. You have numerous countries across which you have the exports that are going. India's exports contribute to nearly 35% of the world market. Of the 35%, most of them account to United States, which 45% of the total exports from India. Besides that, you also have export for Germany, UK, UAE. So those are some of the other important countries where India's export is going. The knotting varies from 16 knots per square of inch to more than 2500 knots per square of inch in carpet industry. So handmade carpets have been highly demanded across the globe. As we said, India partnered with the exhibition Ambient at Germany, and the theme was future is man-made. Similarly, to demonstrate the craft, you have the Khadi hearts that have been established. Craft museum in Delhi is one of the efforts. You also have the handicraft gifts and fair that has been held biannually, that's two times a year every time. Then some of the important arts other than those that we have discussed include the Zardozi art. You have the chikankari in Uttar Pradesh, the Kutch embroidery from Gujarat, the wooden toys from Karnataka. So those are some of the major crafts that we talk about. Numerous market initiatives, market development assistance have been coming up. There has been an online portal which is important in the name of India Handloom Bazaar, where people can bring in their products and sell those through an online portal. Similarly, you have Banarasi sarees, you have the wooden crafts from Bastar, You have terracotta from Villanor. So those are some of the unique characteristics under GI tag that we have talked about. When it comes to economic growth, we are trying to link textile to tourism. So nearly 100 miles, 100 kilometers away, 1000 kilometers away, places that are there. For example, in Andhra Pradesh, you have Tirupati, and in Odisha, you have Raghurajpur. Those have been connected with the idea of textile with tourism. You have a lot of direct and indirect employment ranging to nearly 43 lakhs in handloom activity. Handicrafts, you have Panchan initiatives. So Pehchan initiative is very, very important. As we said, numerous artisans have come up with this Pehchan initiative. They can utilize their skills, have a marketplace to sell out the products. Similarly, the benefits could be passed on, and the Cotton Corporation of India has been working hard to check out the challenges that are coming up in the textile sector. You also have a lot of competition coming up with the synthetic fiber and the other countries, the competing countries like Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and Pakistan, which have zero duty access that has been given. A very good article in this edition is by Sayyeda Hamid, and this article talks about the Ahilyabai Holkar, who originally dwelt from Bid region in Maharashtra and finally decided to have the Narmada wave and the various wave patterns with the weaving that were ultimately the source of livelihood for the people in the Maheshwar town where she finally ruled. And you had a river center that was built very close to the Ahilyabai's palace. A lot of symbolic arts were developed, but slowly and gradually, 3 decades ago, we saw only 25 of such looms were left. Later on, from his own generation, you had the Richard Holkar, who started this wave again. And the Nawari sari, which was 9 yard, was converted into a 6 yard sari. And finally, you have, as of now, nearly 1,750 looms that are there. Each of the family has their own two-room houses with two looms that are being given. As a result, the cost has increased, but yet you have a lot of facilities for the people there, and the artisans are really doing well. They are earning around 100 to 150 per day, and they do get a pension on retirement. So that's a story that has its own historical background, rising from the rise of the Holkar dynasty. Again, the very important thing to understand is, during that time at British Empire, that was a fear that there has always been a competition from Birmingham. So what the idea was, that all those weavers who would be weaving for these dynasties would have, they were so much loyal that they would have their thumb cut so that they could not create competition for the Birmingham mills. So that's very, very important, and that's how the system developed. You had the dhake of malmal, that was such fine kind of cloth that could pass through a ring. So that was the level of artisan or the craftsmanship that was developed, and that is something that we are trying to preserve. So as we said, it requires very low capital investment. With e-commerce, e-platform coming up, you have online portals where these could be sold off. Muradabad, known for brass. You have Saharanpur, known for wooden crafts. Firozpur for glass. You have Sanganer for printed textile. Jaipur for exotic quilts. Then you have Jodhpur for wrought iron furnitures that have been made. So Narsanghpur in Andhra Pradesh is known for lace handicrafts. So those are the kind of various crafts that have been popular across India. When it comes to textile, definitely India has been doing pretty good. You have India as the second largest producer of the silk. 18% of the silk is being produced in India. It's also one of the largest manufacturer of or producer of cotton clothes after China. You have the second largest export that goes from India. However, the discarded, outdated technology is one of the major barriers in the textile manufacturing sector. Similarly, you have hand looms which need to be upgraded every time. So perfection, bringing in mechanization, machines have been a really good challenge. We are also talking about the various qualification pack under the National Skill Qualification Committee. You have 80% of the workforce which is engaged in the textile has been refined. We are focusing more on exports rather than the local use. So handloom industry, elevating the problems of handloom industry, bringing in more secure employment opportunities is one of the main ideas. Now Khadi so far was an idea for Swaraj or self-sustenance. However, now it has become from Khadi to fashion. So we are moving towards a era where we are trying to bring in Khadi into revolution for a fashion, and then you have the Khadi Mitra, which is the innovation forms that have been introduced. Now from the Northeast you have lots and lots of development. Most of the textile market in the international field is coming up. You have a lot of jute production that is coming up, manufacturing for cotton, then for silk is some of the major things that we need to address. Now understand this, that there has been a huge difficult terrain that has been seen in the Northeast, but still there are certain things that bind the people in a unity, that's the weaving practices. So Meghalaya is known for very good quality of weaving, Arunachal Pradesh is known for color combinations. Similarly, you have the Shirdupan shawls that are there, you have the Apatani tribe with the jackets that are there. Angami Nagas are known for the Naga shawls that they develop. Tripura is known for its handloom. And similarly, you have a lots and lots of development from Kameng areas, from the Lohit areas, the Tirap areas of Arunachal Pradesh. So these are some of the important weaving professions that we see. Under silk, Assam is the third largest manufacturer in India. Manipur is known for oak tussar. You have Assam, which is mainly known for Muga silk. Tripura is known for mulberry silk. So different part, you have different type of silk that is present. Similarly, carpet weaving has been a major industry. You have Buddhist tribes which are known for the carpet weaving. Mompas and Khovas are some of the major ones that are seen. Similarly, wooden products, metal products have been seen. You have the monasteries where wooden carvings are seen. Sikkim brims are seen mainly with the wooden beams that are there. You have a lot of foam tribes that are seen in Nagaland who are wood carvers. Xylophones, play instruments have been made. Naga art and art and craft has been very, very popular. Similarly, Rengma tribe is known for contribution to blacksmith. You have Shekos, who is one of the best designers from Nagaland. Similarly, you have from different parts of Northeast that is there. The key idea is they are using the locally available sources. They are talking about more textiles that are there, locally available things. So those are some of the major highlights. Then creation of India in a world marketplace. So you have the ambient that was there. As a result, the Future is Handmade was released. You have Neel, which was a modular sofa, which is a kind of traditional technique from the Odisha's Ikat, and merging it with the modern forms was one of the ideas. Similarly, you have one which was the India's wooden craft being merged with the unique grain combination that was seen. You have lot of dynamism that has been seen mainly in the glass industries, brass industries, wooden industries that have been seen. Ministries of handicraft, textile have been promoting them a lot. The tribes, as we have already seen, have been working with their own identification. For example, the Adi Galong tribe of Arunachal Pradesh is known for an identification mark of python. Similarly, in Mizoram, you have two tribes, Lushai and Lai. Lushai is known for puan skirt, and then you have Lai, which is known as thini skirt. So thithni skirt. So those are the kind of craftsmanship that is seen. In Mizoram, you have puan that is seen. So another a different kind of cloth that is being used. The different clothes with their combinations could be directly asked. So white shawl, it is known as thot sefe. Similarly, you have zang, which is a black cloth, a towel cloth, which is kakat badan. So those are the various characteristics that are seen. One more important is zay, which is a decorative weaving that is being done on the cloth. Gullak is again important from the Galong ethnic group. So those are some of the very, very classic characteristics from the Northeast that have been seen. You have black strap loom that is seen. Lot of traditional weaving has been seen. So that's one of the major stories. When it comes to the various crafts, zari is important. Surat has been major center for zari industries. You had the real zari and now you have semi zari. Real zari use the gold and the silver linings. Leather footwear has been extensively developed across India from Chennai, Ranipet, Lucknow, Kanpur. You have lot of leather footwear industries that have been seen. Along with the footwears, you have the jackets, bags, belts that have been built with leather industry. Carpet industry developed from Jammu Kashmir. Then you have parts of Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh where you have carpet developments. Rug production and dari production have been important. Rug mainly in the parts of Uttar Pradesh. Dari mainly in the regions of Panipat. Then Barmer, Jaisalmer in Rajasthan. Then in South India you have Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Warangal regions in Andhra Pradesh where you have the dari production. Handloom production has been across the country in various forms. Now this handloom could be in the form of embroidery, in the form of hand printing. That could be kalamkari, which is by pen, bandhani, which is tie and dye, block printing or batik, that could be seen. Cane and bamboo has been used extensively. So bamboo has been seen in parts of Andhra Pradesh, Assam, and then there are various other sources that have been seen. Filigree and silverware have been one of the major works. Two major clusters for silver filigree. One is in Andhra Pradesh, Karimnagar, and another is in Cuttack, Odisha. The locations have been very, very important. Metalware, the most important is Bidri art. Bidri art is seen from Bidar region in Karnataka. Bidri products range from mainly hookah base, which is the most popular. Similarly, you have the people who were traveling from Iran to Karnataka via the regions of Ajmer and Rajasthan during the Deccan period, started this Bidri alloy, and this alloy is made up of copper and zinc. That's again important. A lot of jewelry development has been seen along the tribal belts. You have blue pottery, red and black pottery, and different forms of pottery that have been seen. One of the major clusters for pottery has been the Akshadhari Khandi in Assam region. Terracotta folk paintings have been very popular. Similarly, Rajasthan fud painting, which is done on piece of cloth, is very, very important. Besides that, you have other forms of painting. Kalamkari from Srikalahasti in Andhra Pradesh is important. Pachchitra from Odisha is important. Madhubani in Bihar, as we all know. So Chitrakari from West Bengal. So those are some of the major forms of paintings that have been popular. Coir twisting is again important. You have Pipli, Bhubaneswar as some of the major centers. Theater and puppet shows have been part of it. So various forms of puppet shows, which we have covered in the separate lecture on puppet craft, has been there. The puppet shows and the theaters have been named by different names in different parts of the country. So we have the list in the handouts. You just need to know those. Similarly, grass, leaf, reed. These are other things through which you have handicrafts that have been made, and some of the major centers are Dehradun in Uttarakhand. You have parts of Goa, Kullu and Midnapur where you have such crafts which are seen. We'll be bringing many important lectures for your Yojana and Kurukshetra. So stay tuned, and you have a lot of things to memorize here. Important for your match the list questions, which kind of art is found in which regions of the country and which tribe has been responsible, or which tribe is associated to which particular art or which particular craft, we could say, is another kind of important question, specifically from the regions of Northeast. So with this, we covered the Yojana April edition. We'll be bringing many videos. Have a wonderful day ahead.